Hey guys, Ed here, and welcome to the Art of Skim Island. What's going on? All right, it's December 31st, last day of the year, last day of 2015. So I just wanted to make a quick video here. I don't promise it won't be long-winded. I know my last couple of videos were kind of long-winded, and if it's apologize for that. If I got some a little bit of negative feedback on that, but working on that. We're gonna do better on that, promise. So, if you guys have any suggestions or things I could do better to keep your interest, let me know. Let me know in the comments. I want to retain your interest, bring you things that you want to see. All right, excuse me. Just really want to go over quick year in review type things. It was a really trying year for me. A lot of personal difficulties that I tried to overcome, and because of that, didn't have a whole lot of build time this year to get a lot of stuff in. But did get something complete, so kind of run down the more finer points of this year. Alright, so first thing was, well, first thing I got completed here, if you remember this little guy here, probably going to be very hard to see. This was the Pumpkin King that was done for the Styrene Syndicate's Halloween Horror Group build. I'm really proud of this guy because I actually entered him in a local contest. The IPMS Butch O'Hare contest, and I was surprised because won this beautiful silver medal, so I was pretty happy with that. It was a good show. I actually ran into Gil from Red Dragon Model Works, Balthazar from the Basement Modeler, and Bob Busking. If I got your name wrong, I apologize, let me know. But anyway, so we're kind of hanging out with those guys for a while. So it was a fun show. But yeah, it was one of my, it was a real surprise actually. They got a nice silver medal for him. So yeah, it was really the only thing that was completed this year. So I'm happy, at least I got something to add for the shelf. All right, so that's that. Put him over here. And just a couple of last or end of the year kit acquisitions that I didn't get have a chance to get on camera and talk about or open it up. But they were Bandai kits. There were gifts. First one, we got the 1/48 scale snow speeder. It was pretty awesome, one of my favorites. Also got the 1/72 scale Resistance TIE Fighter. Alright, I'm not going to open these because a lot of this is already on here and you guys are building them up already. Look, but one of my favorites here. This kit is just awesome. First Order Stormtrooper. And of course, the ever popular, wonderful 1/144th Millennium Falcon. And this is just an absolute superb kit, so I was really glad to add this to my collection. And of course, that's in addition to the last two kits that I had, which was the Revell Master Series 72nd scale Falcon and the Master Series 48 scale TIE Fighter. And the absolute last thing that I picked, it's not a kit, but a really good reference material. And I just actually purchased this today, actually. And I got this from, I don't know where else they saw. You probably find them online, but I got this from Sam's Club. So if anybody wants to look for it, that's where I found mine. This wonderful, beautiful book called In the Cockpit. It's volumes 1 and 2 from the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum. It's forwarded by John Travolta and Robert A. Hoover. Inside more than 80 history-making aircraft. Now what struck me about this book when I was looking at it, and I'm not going to go through the whole book, I don't want to violate any copyright stuff here, but I'm just going to flip through it on this side here. I'm just kind of random. It's got some really, really excellent and beautiful, just about full cockpit shots that I've ever seen in a book. Here's a Messerschmitt Bf 109G6. Just absolute beautiful, beautiful cockpit shots of various, well, over 80 types of aircraft from all eras. I don't know, not too much. I didn't see anything modern in here. Mostly it's strictly vintage from your biplanes to jets from the 60s. Martin EB-75B Canberra. If I said that right, M6A1 Sarin. Something familiar which you guys would know. Boeing B-29 Super Fortress. And there's, let's try to find it real quick. I just passed it up here. We have a Curtiss P-40E Warhawk. And they just, it's pretty much a small pick of the plane, but mostly just your shots of the cockpit. So it's going to provide really excellent reference. And so this was something I just had to grab. Grumman F6 Hellcat. So just one of my books I'm recommending that if you ever get a chance to pick this up, it's really nice, all right? So those were pretty much the last acquisitions that I got for this year. But all in all, it's been a slow growth year, and I'm looking at the clock because I promised I didn't want to get this too long-winded. But I really want to say thank you to everyone who's watched. I want to say thank you to all my subscribers, both long-term and new. We're going to be coming at you in 2016 with some new things and some changes. I'll be adding a couple new segments on here. But again, I'd like to say thanks to everyone who's been watching. If you have any comments or suggestions, please let me know in the comments. And we'll try to make that happen. So to everyone out there, from Ed and all of us here at, it's just me, I don't know why I do that, say all of us here, but from Ed and the Art of Scale Modeling, I want to wish everyone a happy, healthy, and safe new year. All right, and as always, stay happy, stay healthy, and stay modeling. All right, we'll see you in 2016. Take it easy.